Good morning, children. Welcome back to social studies tutorial. I hope you all are well at home. So students, we are going to start a new chapter today, that is understanding government. So students, once the word comes to us government, then what exactly we think, what exactly the government is? So can you imagine the life without the rules or regulations, or like suppose there will be no like control, so what would happen? So similarly, what exactly, there are so many people in an area, and if there would be no control, so they would perform whatever they wanted to do, and just because of this there will be a kind of confusion and chaos. So just to eliminate that situation, what exactly there is the government? The word government is originated from a Latin word, that is governor. So what it means, that is steer a ship or to guide or to rule. So if we talk about politically, a government can be defined as a body that administers or governs a political unit. Here we are talking about a political unit that could be a country or a state. So that is called government. Now what exactly, again we are talking about that why there is a need of a government. So that is like sometimes we have to think that why there is a need of government. So students, since you know that there are so many peoples in our country, and they have started leading settled life. So once they have started their settled life, so definitely there are their different needs and requirements which are increasing day by day. And just to meet with all these requirements, they needed some person who can control or administer them, who can guide them in a better way. Else they'll do whatever they wanted to do, because of which there would be a chaos or confusion. So what happens? So in a modern day government, there are certain functions which a government has to fulfill, and without which we cannot imagine the exact democracy. So what exactly, there are certain functions, these are the administration. What kind of administration government performs? So the government manage the day-to-day affairs of the country, and it provides basic infrastructure like roads, railways, postal and telegraph services, public transport, street lighting, public facilities like parks and libraries, etc. So it maintains relations with other nations. Then the other reason that why do we need government, that is security, because to protect the state from attacks from other countries, that is the basic purpose that the government maintains an armed force. Many a times you have heard about the army, navy, police or so on. So these force consisting just army, air force and navy, governments also have to maintain law and order within the country. Then the next function that a government performs, that is economics. So how government controls the economics? That to ensure the economic security of the country, it controls the finance of the states, issues currencies, controls trade and decides the economic policies of the state. Then it also performs a function of social security by providing appropriate healthcare facilities and old age pension, preventing the discrimination of disadvantaged groups and ensuring equal opportunities to all. So there are different like times of natural disasters that the government rescues and takes care of the affected. The government also protects the natural environment of the state. That all you know that the government tries to keep pollution and overexploitation of resources under control. So what we can conclude, that by understanding these functions, we can easily understand that why there is a need for government. So I hope you understood this session well. We'll continue the remaining chapter. There are the various forms which we are going to learn in our next class. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.